Today for Mousetrap Monday, I have this awesome antique device I'm calling a homemade MacGyver mousetrap. It's one of a kind, and I call it a MacGyver mousetrap because if you've seen that show, he's always taking odds and ends and junk and forming some ingenious contraption to help him escape danger. And that's what this is. It's a bunch of different pieces of junk and reused parts to make a mousetrap, or at least I think it's a mousetrap. If this isn't a mousetrap and you know what it is, please comment and let me know. But the people I bought it from got it from an estate sale where it was sold as a mousetrap. We think it's a mousetrap because it has some features that will let you catch mice. It has a spring-loaded door here that opens and closes, and it leads to this back compartment that has a window screen to keep the animal inside. So the animal goes in here, somehow trips this lever, and it closes on them. Now there's quite a bit about this trap that's a mystery, and I don't know exactly how it works. We'll start by identifying what it's made out of. My dad took a look at this and he recognized these boxes. He said he's seen these before when he was younger as boxes made to hold cheese, big bricks of cheese. It has a dovetail design and grooves here for a lid. Back then when they made packaging for their food, they used high quality wood. They didn't use just cheap plastic, and they could reuse this as other uses. And that's what happened here, is some kind of container, maybe a cheese box that they made as a frame for a mousetrap. This here looks like a door latch, and it has a spring inside, and it's attached to this metal plate, goes up and down. There's a little hole right here that catches on a hook. This almost looks like a piece off a gun, some kind of trigger system, that when you depress it here on the back, it releases it, and that spring pushes the door forward. Pretty ingenious, and makes sense. We have our compartment here with the screen on there, a window screen. What I don't know is what this is. This is a mystery to me because it's a second compartment that comes out, and we have a sight glass, and it's a curved lens. It might be out of a spectacles or reading glasses, and I don't know if the purpose is for an animal to come in and see a light in there and want to enter because of the light. I don't know, but when you remove it, you see a wire here, and then you'll see where it's carved out on the side and attached to a metal knob that turns. What that is when you open it up and you can see inside, there's a metal round disc on a wire that opens and closes. And it almost looks like a piece off a carburetor or something like that. I don't know if that's part of the trigger system where the animal enters, comes in and somehow twists that and makes the trap go off. It's a mystery to me, but to make this work, I'm just gonna close this and not use this back part. I don't know what it does, but I need to figure out a way to have the mouse enter the trap and then depress this. Now it doesn't work too great when it's sitting on its side. Sometimes it sticks, and I found it works much better if you set it on end like this and use gravity to have it come down. It comes down much quicker. We'll have to watch, because when we set this off, the mouse's tail is probably going to be sticking out of this. Now how do you attach it so that this will go off when a mouse enters? I'm going to set this up and show you what I did to make this as a functional mouse trap. In the spirit of MacGyver, all I needed was a string and one piece of wire that looks like this. I'm going to show you how I make this work now. So like I said, all we have to do to make this work is depress this little latch and it will release the door. And to set it, you just pull it up. And the way I made this work is I bent a piece of wire where this end acts as a lever and wedges right there on the trigger. It's very light, so if you barely touch this, pry it back, it closes. And that's pretty easy to set off. We'll reset it. And what I did is I'm gonna tie a piece of string that's behind the trap down to a bait that's inside the chamber. So the mouse will come in, pull the little bait, and then when it pulls it down, this lever will go off on the trigger system and will catch our mouse. It's pretty light and sensitive, so you have to be careful setting it. You wanna get this wire sit just perfectly on there where it balances and doesn't set off the trap. The mouse will come through, grab the bait, pull the string on the end of that wire. As it goes down, it catches it. This usually falls down, but we have a mouse inside. I really wanna see if this system will work. So let's go set this up in the barn with motion cameras and see if we can catch a mouse in our antique homemade MacGyver mouse trap. Thank you. I went to go check our antique homemade MacGyver mouse trap, and the door's tripped. You flip it over in the back, and through the screen, you can see a mouse there that really wants to get out. Since this is a live animal trap, we're gonna let it go. So flip it around here, and then we'll pull that door, and he's free to go. Overall, a really good design. I still have no idea how this is supposed to work, but with a little string and a piece of wire, I was able to catch mice with it. A really cool antique mouse trap or whatever it is, but we were able to make it work, and it worked well.